Welcome, my friends. Welcome to a new episode of Coffea TV. Coffea TV is a channel where we want to talk about specialty coffee, but we're concentrating mostly on the production of the coffee grain. Coffee moves an industry that it's unimaginable. Not only when you see the green bean forward, all the processes that are derived from a coffee grain, but what we're concentrating on mostly is from the green bean backwards, the most important part of coffee, which is the growth of the grain of the plant. All the hardships that people must go in order for us, the consumer, to have the best cup of coffee possible. Unfortunately, in this big industry, multi-billion dollar industry, those stories, those people, their effort are not known. And the people who work mostly are the ones who are making the least amount of money in this multi-billion dollar industry. So the reason why we at Coffea TV are making these stories, we're sharing them with you, is so that we as consumers become more aware of all these hardships, of all this work, of everything that it entails for us in the morning to either grind, or if the coffee's grounded already, just put it in a machine and put some boiled water and get a good cup of coffee. For them, the story is completely different. They have to work for long hours amongst the heat in very steep hills. They have to work in between the plagues, mosquitoes, black flies that are constantly biting them in order for them to have to work and get something to get on their tables. We've been going around Colombia for the past 4 years. This is our fifth trip to Colombia. We've been visiting a lot of coffee plantations. We've been seeing a lot of processes, how they're doing the traditional coffee growing, and we're mostly concentrating on specialty coffee. The reason being, specialty coffee is the one that can enable them to have a decent means of income. Right at the moment, because coffee is sold in the stock market, they're barely making $1.40 a pound. That doesn't even cover the cost of producing the coffee. They're losing, but yet we have other people, intermediary people mostly, who are making thousands or even millions of dollars. The idea here is for us as consumers to become more aware, to understand that if we buy specialty coffee, if we ask our specialty coffee stores what treatment are they giving the coffee growers, if we go to supermarkets, our favorite supermarket, and we go and look for the certificate, we are helping these people being able to make a decent means of income and a decent mean and very well deserved means of a good life. So we want to invite you to go with us through this journey that we have been doing for the past week in the municipality of Bruselas, in the state of Huila, in the southern part of the state of Huila, in Colombia, South America. Two years ago, while we were visiting Expo Especiales, which is the biggest coffee fair in Colombia, and as I believe in South America, we were able to meet this group, this association, Specialty Coffee Association from the region of Bruselas. They go by the name of Café Salomón or Salomón Coffee. There I was able to meet a fantastic woman, a woman that as we get to know her more, we're seeing how valuable she is for her community, her leadership skills, how concerned she is with improving the lives, not only for herself and her family, but for her community as well. Her name is Ana Gloria Rodriguez Triana. Ana Gloria has been developing her plantation. In only 4 years, she has been able to restructure the production of this coffee plantation. She has been receiving honors, and she has been winning prizes for the quality of coffee that she and her team are able to produce. We're gonna be able to see how she practically doesn't have any life, because every day she is constantly taking care of her people, the ones who work for her, the quality of coffee. They're trying to sell the best coffee that they can possibly be able to grow. And for the enjoyment of all of us consumers. So come on in with us. I will be sharing with you all that it entails for a woman, coffee grower, a community leader, to be able to get the best coffee quality possible, and as well how she can and what she's doing to help out her community. So my name is Mari King, and this is Cofea TV. Keep up with us.
Mi nombre es Ana Gloria Rodríguez Triana, tengo 52 años, llevo viviendo en esta zona hace 28 años, con la misma experiencia en café. Hace 4 años empecé a implementar procesos para cafés especiales en mi empresa cafetera. La finca mía se llama Finca Villa Valentina, Los Cedros. Estoy ubicada en el corregimiento de Bruselas, municipio de Pitalitos, departamento de Huila y país Colombia.
Notice this is a woman carrying on the coffee she picked to be brought in. Buenas tardes. That's about 30 kilos of coffee right there. That's over 60 pounds that woman was carrying. Notice the difference between him. Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes.
He's got about 150 pounds.
Mi mano de obra, el 80% son mujeres. Porque la mujer es la que más le da la calidad a la recolección. Con ella garantizo que mi recolección sea netamente roja. Adquirí la tecnología Ecomil. La tecnología Ecomil es un proceso donde el beneficio se requiere de muy poquita agua y muy poquito la parte eléctrica. O sea, de eso tengo el sistema de secado, que es un sistema en bandejas donde garantizo de que el choque de calor no es intenso. El secado es un secado lento, donde ese café que va a entrar a ese tipo de secado es de 15 a 18 días. Entonces eso hace que los atributos del grano sean más concentrados y afloren más al momento de tostarlo y de catarlo. Les vamos a contar qué estamos haciendo aquí con las mujeres de nuestra asociación. En el sur de Pitalito llegó Nestlé, Nescafé Plan, ¿no? El programa se llama Nescafé Plan, y están asociados con Federación de Cafeteros. ¿Cuál es la idea de este programa? Hacer renovación de los cafetales con variedades resistentes. En este preciso momento estamos trabajando el Castillo Tampa. Entonces nos buscaron las asociaciones de las mujeres. Tenemos una asociación muy grande en Pitalito que se llama Las Chapoleras. Somos más de 300 asociadas al grupo. Y nos dieron ese programa, implementar 711 mil colinos de café.
Buenos días, mi nombre es Jaime Humberto Barrios Rodríguez. Soy agrónomo, trabajo en la Secretaría de Desarrollo Económico del municipio de Pitalito. Y bueno, el motivo de estar involucrado en el proyecto Nescafé Plan con el Comité de Cafeteros y las Mujeres Chapoleras de acá del municipio de Pitalito es, digamos, colaborar en el tema de la asistencia técnica, de visitar los 12 núcleos que conforman esta asociación, los cuales están involucrados en el proyecto Nescafé Plan.
I'm visiting a new concept that has been introduced in this region. They're trying to help out the women coffee growers of the area. So along with Nestle Corporation, Nespresso, and the Coffee Federation, and the Association of Specialty Coffee, Salomon Coffee, they are lending this area so that the women around the area can start growing the coffee plants. There are about 771,000 plants that have to be grown in order to renew the coffee production of the region. This is in order for Nestle to buy the coffee from this area. So what the Federation and Nestle is doing is they're paying 90% of all the costs of labor and all, the growers, in this case the ladies, would only have to pay 10%. They will be sponsored, and that's another means of income that they will receive besides the coffee season.
Mi mayor preocupación en este momento son los precios del café. La verdad es que nosotros como productores no estamos recibiendo las ganancias que los intermediarios sí se lo están quedando. Nosotros somos los que producimos, nosotros somos los que cuidamos la tierra, los que cuidamos estas matas. Y eso es un sacrificio duro porque el trabajo es 6 días a la semana, llueva, trueno, relampague o haga sol, está uno aquí porque las matas no dan tiempo y hay que consentirlas, hay que hacer las labores. Y ve uno que va a llevar a su café a venderlo y son centavos lo que nosotros estamos recibiendo. Vemos que en otros países una taza de café fácilmente puede valer $8 y aquí no recibimos sino centavos, menos del dólar. Entonces, como productor nunca vamos a poder progresar, nunca vamos a poder tener una calidad de vida mucho mejor que la que el que se la está tomando el café o el que lo está transformando. Yo invito a todos los consumidores que les gusta el buen café, compren café especial y cómprenos a nosotros los productores directamente. Quitémonos esa cantidad de intermediarios que hay entre usted y yo. Yo puedo venderle a usted directamente mi café. Necesito que haya un acercamiento. No quiero intermediarios de fulano de tal, o de tal empresa. No. Quitemos los que se están enriqueciendo en medio y hagamos un buen trabajo. Usted me compra a muy buen precio mi café y usted se lleva un excelente café para su casa o para su tierra. Invito a los tostadores extranjeros, invito a los turistas que vienen a nuestro país. No compren café, pidan café especial, producido por un cafetero, por un cafetero que ha hecho un buen proceso, que se sacrifica todo un año para que en 4 meses usted tenga de nuestra mejor cosecha una taza de café en su mesa.
Muchas gracias.
Con mucho gusto, amiga María. Te quiero mucho.
Mira, también.